Heath Bradburn, sponsored by Jim Bass Cars and Trucks.
And welcome back, everybody. The time right now is 12:18, and looking out of all four angles of our Cactus Sky Cam, not too bad. I mean, we have a few thin clouds. It's kind of adding a slight layer of covering over us, but otherwise, again, it's not too bad to start off our afternoon. And we haven't really seen this kind of temperature to start off our afternoon for a while. 80 degrees right now, humidity down to 36%. Those winds are still coming in from the north, 22 miles an hour to kick off our afternoon hours. Temperatures around the region, we got mid-70s to the low 80s around the Concho Valley. So again, not too bad to start off. I mean, tomorrow is the first day of fall, so we are going to have kind of a quick preview of that, and we are also seeing those stronger winds coming in from the north, anywhere from 15 to 25 miles per hour across the Concho Valley. Slightly less wind speed coming in Junction and Mason, around 11 and 12 miles an hour. And we continue to see warmer temperatures staying to the south. That cold front is just slowly moving across. Not as strong, though, because it's kind of the tail end of this, and it's going to be seeing more so kind of impacting tomorrow. That's where our cold front continues to push through. Like I said, it's just the tail end of it. It stretches all the way up into the Great Lakes area. We still have a few lingering showers in portions of the Concho Valley, more staying to the southeastern corner around Junction and Mason at this time. For the rest of us, we're going to continue to see a little bit of cloud cover as we continue going through our afternoon hours. Those winds will be fairly consistent from the north, up to 20 miles per hour as we get through the rest of our day. And our highs are not going to be that much warmer than what we have right now. We're looking at low to mid 80s across the region, with the exception Sterling City is actually only going to get to 79, and then 87 for Junction and Mason today. Tonight's lows, we're going to be hitting the 50s, so it is going to feel a little bit cooler than what we've been used to for the past several months here. We're going to have a decrease in cloud cover, and then tomorrow, plenty of sunshine. We're looking at highs in the upper 70s to low 80s once again to kick off our first day of fall. We're not going to be seeing a whole lot more activity going on other than the clouds pushing through. Sunny skies tomorrow, and then heading into Thursday, we'll start to see a mix of sun and cloud as we get to the second half of this week. And to kick off fall, we're also going to have more dry conditions coming through. That moisture is going to end up being pushed into the Gulf and beyond. So it's going to be cooler and a little bit more on the dry side. And those temperatures are going to be sticking in the 80s as we continue through the rest of the week, into the weekend, and into next week. Could see some scattered showers coming in starting on Monday with a mix of sun and clouds as well. You're watching KLST News.